What's up guys, I'm Dhirendra Singh Jambal and welcome to Bite the Bullet. In this video, we're really going to get to the meat of shooting. Before I get into the position of shooting, I would like to clarify there are many schools of thought in building a shooting position. So my coach was Suma Shirur and she herself is a world record holder and an Olympic finalist. This is based on what she taught me. In this video, guys, you'll have the privilege not to see my face, but you'll have to see my legs because there are certain aspects in the lower body position that I need to show you closely, and I can't show you by wearing my shooting kit. So let's move on to the position, guys. I'm really excited. Hope you are as well. So the assumption here is that you will be a right-handed shooter. Now, if you're a left-handed shooter, then whatever I teach you, just mirror it to the other side. So we'll start with our left leg. Assuming the target is in this direction, then your left leg should be perpendicular to the target. Now, what I mean by perpendicular is, if I draw a straight line from the target all the way till the ground, it should cut it in the middle of my foot. Now, the right leg itself is a little stretched out. Now, this angle can be varied based on how comfortable your body is. So, you can move it out, you can move it in, or you can keep it parallel to your left leg. Now, when you are adjusting your right leg, you need to find the most comfortable position for yourself. That's the idea of adjusting the right leg. Now, there will be about 60 to 80% of weight on my left leg and 20 to 40% weight on my right leg. And why is this? So now if you see, my body is fairly centered. So I have about 50% of weight on my right leg and 50% of weight on my left leg. What I want you to do over here is, once you've taken your position, I need you to push your hips towards the target. Now, when you push your hips towards the target, you see my left leg is almost straight and my right leg is just a support leg for my entire position. Now, why we do this is so there's a good base to place my elbow. I'll come to that when we are working on the upper body position. Now, your toes should be on the ground. They shouldn't be floating up, and ensure that your entire sole of the foot is on the ground. So the tendency is to have the weight slightly on the outer edges of this foot or on the outer edges of this foot, sometimes even the inner edges of the right leg, and the weight is push towards the heels, but just ensure that the contact is strong on the whole foot. There is no extra weight in one part or the other part of the foot. And ensure that your knees are straight, but they are not locked. They should be soft, but they should be straight as well. So they shouldn't be bent like this. They should be straight. This shouldn't be bent, this should be straight as well. But it shouldn't be locked, it should just be soft. So these are the things that you need to work on. I'll just go over it once again. Just ensure that your left foot is perpendicular to the target. So how you would find that, just draw one line and your left foot should be in the center of that. Your right foot, the angle can vary based on your comfort. You can have it parallel to your left foot, you can have it slightly outside, you can have it even slightly inside, your toes facing inwards. That I leave it up to you and what is most comfortable to you and your position. Now, once you've set your foot position, you need to straighten your knee and push your hip towards the target. So what will happen then is, your left leg will be straight, your right leg will be slightly slanted outwards, and your right leg is your support leg, Your left leg is the load bearing weight. So your left leg will have 60 to 80% of the weight and your right leg will have about 20 to 40%. In my previous video, I mentioned your trouser doesn't have too many flexible parts because once your position is set, you don't want to move it much. Everything in your lower body is straight. You're not really moving around too much. So that's the lower body position. This is known as the foundation of your position in standing shooting. So it's important to have a good base and then building layers on that becomes much simpler. If you have any questions, guys, please write it down. If you want me to make a more elaborate video on this, please let me know. If you want me to cover particular aspects, please let me know. I'll add it after I finish my next video. For now, guys, work on this and let me know if this helped you. Happy shooting, guys, and stay safe, and I will see you in my next video. Bye.